Hello, I'm Daria Fissoun, and in this video, we'll be going over the powerful quality control tools available in the Pro version of OmniScope. This collection of tools provides objective readouts of your video signal, allowing you to quickly and accurately assess it for deliverable conformity. In the Scopes menu, open up Min-Max to reveal the peak, low, and high luminance levels for each frame of the image. Right-click and go to the settings to dim the source image behind the Min-Max graph for an alternative view. This tool is particularly useful when working in HDR because it allows you to monitor how much luminance levels fluctuate from frame to frame and clip to clip. In the QC menu, select Blanking Detection to locate letterboxing and pillarboxing in your media. After activating Blanking Detection, use the controls underneath to set margin thresholds, change the error color, and the signal range. Blanking detection is helpful when working on timelines with various camera sources, such as a documentary that uses a mixture of analog and digital video formats, or in sequences that feature stock footage. By detecting blanking, you can scale up your media to match the aspect ratio of the overall project. You can set the red overlay to blink to better grab your attention during review. Right-click the source viewer, go to Settings and the QC tab, and activate Blinking Alert Overlay. This is even possible to do if you are working with an aspect ratio within a container frame. Go to your input settings and set your aspect ratio in the signal drop-down menu. So, if you're working on a 235 aspect ratio project within a 16:9 container, you can still check for errors within the 235 frame of the image, ignoring the 16:9 resolution ratio of the signal. In the Source Viewer contextual menu, you will find the Data Analyzer. Left-click and drag within the viewer for an RGB readout of the pixel immediately under and surrounding your mouse pointer. Use this to quickly verify the accuracy of your signal bit depth and for general monitoring of RGB values, like when working with corporate colors. Go to the QC menu to open the Single Line Mode tool. This tool will limit your scope's readout to a single horizontal line of the image. Use it to quickly match color charts, assess the color values of specific objects, and correct light sources and shadows. The numeric value of the slider refers to the pixel row number of the image. When you activate HDR stats in the QC menu, OmniScope will begin to detect MaxFall and MaxCLL HDR statistics in real time. This metadata is required for HDR10 deliverables. In a sequence, these stats indicate the maximum value of the frame average light level and maximum light level of a single pixel. Stats are shown for both the current frame and the global average accumulated up until that point of the analysis. And finally, one of the most powerful tools in the QC menu is the timeline, which gives you real-time analysis of all incoming frames for project-wide quality assessment. Errors and non-analyzed frames are highlighted red. To change the color of the highlight, go to the Options menu, select Preferences, and click the swatch box under the QC Timeline header. The QC timeline can be configured to show up to 9 tracks. The timecode reflects the one in your NLE timeline. The Gamut row will show the percentage of illegal Gamut pixels in the form of a graph. The red line indicates the current legal threshold, as established in the Gamut Check tool, and the blue line shows the actual Gamut values of the video. This graph helps to visualize Gamut legality changes over time and where the threshold exceeds legal values. HDR shows the fluctuation in the light levels of the footage, allowing you to produce a project with consistent highlights and brightness levels. Please note that HDR stats have to be enabled in the QC menu for this event to work. And this feature is not limited to HDR media. You can activate it for an SDR project in order to monitor the luminance changes in your edit. When working with documentaries or long takes, you can monitor the change in light to figure out where you might need to perform keyframed corrections. Blanking highlights areas of your timeline where frame blanking has been detected, allowing you to locate and address those clips specifically. HDR Gamut detects out-of-gamut values when the input signal is Rec 2020 or its equivalent, Rec 2100. These errors occur when colors fall out of acceptable range for HDR broadcast and digital standards, which can lead to significant issues in post-production and distribution. This setting also needs to be activated in the QC menu to run as a timeline event. Silence highlights sections of the timeline with no audio, helping you spot if Atmos or music tracks have been disabled. The waveform represents your audio levels throughout the timeline. This is a good way to visually assess if the volume levels may have crept up during the mixing process and ensure even playback throughout the project. Loudness gauges the loudness levels relative to a predefined loudness meter. The thumbs row at the bottom allows you to visually assess which section of a clip or timeline you are viewing as a sequence of thumbnails. You can adjust the height of the tracks by dragging them. Drag the name of a track to rearrange it on the list. Right-click in the timeline window to reveal more controls. Here, you can reset the timeline. Clear any bookmarks that you may have applied using the Steam Deck or Command or Control B shortcut, or import and export the timeline in the QCD format. You can also export QC events as EDL markers. When you open your NLE, choose to import timeline markers from EDL. Your timeline will then be populated by the QC markers, making it easier to spot and address quality control issues. Thank you for watching this video. And if you'd like to know more about the many tools available in OmniScope, check out the video description for the official documentation in the Time and Pixels website. We also appreciate you liking the video and encourage you to subscribe if you'd like to be informed of future developments at OmniScope.